We're doing little bits of cable
management.
You're
doing all the cable management.
I'm doing all the cable management. Okay. Blue LEDs.
Sorry for making you do all that work, but...
I don't care.
I'm not good at cable management.
Okay, so this is a motherboard header. All these are motherboard headers. And that's the USB 3. This is Molex to your fan thing. So that can go... What? Oh, you're leaving me? Okay. I see how it is. Let's take that off. Not really, no.
Very good, because I don't want to eat, like, right in front of you.
Oh, I thought you were going to say, okay, good, because I wasn't planning on feeding you.
Oh, okay. Well, that too.
Gee, thanks, buddy. Yay, you now have USB ports. You're eating anyway? You're horrible! I hate you! You're not my real dad!
Not fun. Where's my phone at?
I stole it.
Where'd
and then
you
I
go?
Sold it to poor people. I sold it to charity. What is this thing? Why is it shaped like that?
I'd like you to support charity. Yeah,
that's
we
mean.
Would.
It's like, yes, I would support charity. I just don't have money. I hate that ad so much.
I know.
I hate Mobile Strike. I'm like, I'm not playing with guys!
Chills. Number 9. Who killed Cock Robin? Pendant
what are you watching?
This nonsensical poem casually introduces children to the morbid concepts of death, murder, and funeral preparations by using cute little animals and insects as examples.
Cute little animals and insects?
In the original poem, which is only 4 verses long, a sparrow calmly admits to shooting the bird known as Cock Robin with a bow and arrow. No explanation is given, just a heartless murder without a motive. Apparently, this was not enough to scare children, so roughly 3 decades later, an extended version has a fly watch with fascination as Cock Robin slowly dies from the arrow. A fish
oh
who collects his blood in a dish for who knows what. A beetle offering to sew a death shroud for Cock Robin to wear as a ghostly shade. An owl grave digger. And all sorts of other non-human participants eagerly volunteering to perform some sort of death-related chore at the funeral. Eventually, Victorian-era illustrations were added, and that's where things take a really bizarre turn. A fly dressed in a turncoat gracefully bows towards the reader and beckons for them to embrace death. A frenzied bull rings a church bell with muscular human-like arms.
Ew.
And large groups of animals bawl their heads off over the anguish of losing a loved one. Their human-like expressions are disturbing. While the content is not overly gory, the subject matter is quite heavy for a children's audience, which is why Who Killed Cock Robin deserves an honorable mention on this list of great tales. Number 8, The Monkey and the Crab. This dark tale of greed and revenge comes from ancient China. A crab grows a persimmon's tree, and once the fruit grows ripe, he enlists the help of a monkey to pick them from the branches. Instead of sharing the fruit with the crab like a good monkey, however, the monkey decides instead to bludgeon the cheerful talking crab to death by hurling unripe persimmons until his head was smashed and his shell was broken in several places.
Oh my god.
You've got to love the gory specifics, especially in a children's story. At this point, the legend splits into 2 variations. In one, the crab is pregnant, which adds a whole other level of depravity to the story by essentially turning the monkey into a womanizer. In this version, the crab's young breaks free from their mother's corpse and seek revenge by peeling the monkey's eyes open and gleefully burning him to death. After this brutal execution, everyone lives happily ever after. In the second version, the crab's son comes across his father's corpse and somehow enlists the help of a bee and a living chunk of rock to deliver a torture-filled demise that ends with the crab victoriously punching the monkey's head off, with absolutely no moral whatsoever. In ancient Chinese fables, the lines between good and evil are often intentionally blurred, and this is a perfect example. Number 7, oh, Pinocchio. Shit. Disney went to great lengths to omit the gorier parts from the original Pinocchio, written in 1883 by Italian author Carlo Collodi. For example, you might remember how the wooden boy's nose grows after lying. But do you recall when he slowly, very slowly, burns his legs off while trying to dry his feet by the oven?
No.
Remember the scene where Pinocchio smashes Jimmy Cricket to death because he doesn't appreciate the nagging advice?
No.
No, of course not. In the original version of Pinocchio, however, these scenes exist. The talking cricket, as he's known as not Jiminy Cricket from Disney, is horrifically murdered by Pinocchio with blunt force. When describing how Pinocchio took a hammer from the bench and threw it with all his strength at the talking cricket, the narrator creepily addresses the audience as, "My dear children." There's no mistaking it. Here, a violent murder is being explained in real time to children. The poor cricket fell from the wall, dead, according to the narrator, only to come back as a ghost later on to give more advice from beyond the grave. When the talking cricket returns, Pinocchio offers himself to be bludgeoned to death so long as his family is spared. The talking cricket has absolutely no intentions of harming anybody. But what a thought on Pinocchio's behalf. That is one emotionally disturbed puppet. Did we also mention that Pinocchio was hanged by an angry mob? And that was where the story was originally supposed to end, until the editors convinced Collodi to lighten up and write an ending that wouldn't send kids screaming into their mother's aprons.
True.
Somehow, these scenes did not make the Disney cut. Number 6, The Five Chinese Brothers. Let's move away to have his head cut off, and by Jimmy Crack Corn. Most people have happily sung the chorus of this song at least once as a child, blissfully unaware that they are actually reciting a song deeply rooted in slavery, misery, alcoholism, and possibly even murder. A full examination of the...
That's like friggin' morbid.
Well, it's a Friday and I'm hosting, you know what that means, Haiku Fridays. Today's submission is from Tim. Windows 10 has crashed. I am the blue screen of death. No one hears your screen. Super deep, Tim. Kind of scary. Official sore improvements that standard HDTV owners can expect. They're also very...
I'm Batman.
Hey, Rick, what is this?
Everyone knows what that is, Morty. Everyone
okay,
has one.
Rick, I think I've got it.
Is this place 3D? Is this a VR?
Yes, Morty. We did it. We finally did it. We're coming to VR.
Rick and Morty on VR.
Welcome back! I was so happy. Hi, Michael. Michael, come back. Okay, then. What a wonderful break.
All right. I fixed my hair. Took care of everything but the power supply and the graphics card. We're gonna be putting those things in last. Cable management, we're gonna take care of that way last after everything else. George sort of did most of it. He's fixing stuff and he's dancing behind me right now. Enjoy that previous footage of me running in the 90s. So, we need to go back to the 90s, George.
We do.
We need to run back to the
90s. I wasn't born in the 90s. We'll go find 1 week old Dan.
This is the computer. Yay.
Let me.
There it is.
Look how pretty it is.
It's very pretty.
We got the liquid cooler installed. We got the RAM, motherboard, CPU, all that.
It's gorgeous.
I got some of the front panel connectors hooked up. And what we're going to do next, the hard drive.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we took not one, not two,
not three.
Not three.
But four.
But four hard drive cases out.
All out, just for cable management.
That way we'd have just a tiny bit more room for this tube in his massive freaking triple fan graphics card, which hopefully fits. I'm going to be super sad if it doesn't fit.
Yay!
I don't even know if you can see me.
Yeah.
I'm going to be super sad if it doesn't fit. So, all the way on this very, very bottom hard drive cage is where we're going to put his hard drive. We're going to put his SSD here. The specs are all at the beginning of the video. Go check those out. Huh?
Nothing, no, we're ready.
Oh, okay. Okay, so are we ready to continue?
Oh, sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
What are we doing next? Hard drive?
Fuck it.
Give me a mint. Give me a mint!
One or two?
I don't care.
Two.
Why, thank you, friend.
Look, my friend.
Mints. Look at your bed.
I lost my pendant. I don't know where it is.
Your pendant?
Yeah, my necklace pendant. These gifts.
Just look at all of these. Look at all this. There's just stuff everywhere. They got more stuff here. We got a side panel. We got a whole freaking. I don't know where your necklace pendant is. I didn't even know you had a necklace pendant.
I need to find it.
I don't know where it's at.
I have a necklace.
Well, I didn't see it.
I have a pendant.
Watch this part. Like, the time lapse, all I just cut the audio.
I know.
That's so fun.
Destiny,
that's not a cool song.
Destiny, the Mountain Dew.
Is this like MLG version?
You're just like, oh god.
I don't think the camera's catching this, Mike.
No, just cable man. Do we need all the rest of these cables too? Right?
Yeah. Oh wait, do we have two SATA? Oh wait.
Rock with me,
you kill yourself.
It's so unnecessarily loud.
Song. So
is this from Sam Spring?
Whoa!
What?
Is it on loop? Or is this regular version?
It's a regular version.
Have you ever seen the dude who made Darude Sandstorm out of floppy drives?
No.
Go look up the video. Michael, it's your favorite treat, silica gel. Eat up.
Ah,
oh look, here's power supply screws. What is this? Hey, this is a power supply tester.
The camera just sees me dancing.
I don't think it sees your face.
It knows what I'm wearing.
Dance. Dance for my amusement. Okay.
Yeah,
that's
your
graphics card.
Yeah. Which one do I plug it into?
VGA, since VGA 1.
Oh, okay.
Oh wait, do I already have it? No, it's CPU. So yeah, do VGA 1, and then I need to plug in VGA 2. That's just right there. Have you touched your graphics card yet?
No.
Okay, I'll let you do that first, because it's yours.
What about these?
That's a splitter. Okay. If you had 6-pin, you would plug it into here and it turns it into an 8-pin, but you don't need that for that. Let's see, this is SATA 1, and then what is this? Why do we have a third VGA cable? Oh, okay, guess we don't need this. So I can go back in there. We do need this. This is SATA 2. I missed the silica gel. It's touching the graphics card. Okay,
this is all we need.
This should be it. Okay, turn your case a little bit to the side. And then I'm gonna move the camera.